How to change your email address on Gmail. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is actually a relatively common question. How to change your email address if you're using Google's Gmail? Well, the problem of course is that you can't change it directly. I'll describe why and give you a couple of alternatives. So why can't you just change your email address? Well, the problem is very simple. Your email address identifies your account. A different email address implies a different account. So you can't change your email address without changing your account. And that means that everything in your account is not transferred over when you create another account. Everything in your account is in your account. A different email address, a different account. That's what it boils down to. And that's how you get a different email address. If you want to change your email address, you end up needing to create a new Gmail account. Once you've done so, you have a new account with a new email address. The email address that you wanted to change to. But it's not quite what you wanted, right? What people want is to be able to change the email address without changing the account, without losing all their email, without having anything else changed. They just want it to be a different email address. Doesn't work like that. When you open a new account with a new email address, you now have two accounts. Your old account with your old email address and your new account with your new email address. How do you manage this? Well, I have two workarounds that might make it easy-ish to deal with having two accounts. Workaround number one, a desktop email program like Thunderbird or Microsoft Office's Outlook program or any of a number of other desktop email programs. What you can do with those programs is configure both accounts. Configure it to access your old account number one, configure it to access your new account number two. You now have all of your email from both accounts in the same place. You still have two accounts, you still have two email addresses, but at least you're managing it all from a single place, the desktop email program on your computer. Now, there's another approach that is perhaps a little bit more along the lines of what you're looking to do, but it requires a little bit of configuration in Gmail itself. So let's go over here to Gmail and we'll take a look at exactly what that means. Here we are in Gmail. I'm not going to switch to Chrome, and I know that I've made some changes recently, so we'll just go ahead and get rid of that message. The feature that I'm going to use is the ability of one Gmail account to check the email of another Gmail account. Essentially, it basically centralizes both accounts in a single Gmail interface. I do this constantly. In fact, it's how I manage almost all of my email. Yes, I have a personal Gmail account, I have a work Gmail account, but those Gmail addresses are actually never specified anywhere. I don't use them publicly. What I use, of course, are like leo@askleo.com. I have my Gmail account configured to check email from that account and bring it into Gmail. How do you do that? Let me show you. Here we are in my askleotest@gmail.com account. What we need to do is click on the gear icon in the upper right. Click on See All Settings. This is buried in All Settings. The item to click on is Accounts and Import. Now, you can see here that there are several different features associated with this section. The one that we care about is this, check mail from other accounts. You would click on Add a Mail Account. You would specify the email address that you're trying to check from. In my case, I would have specified leo@askleo.com. You might have specified old, whatever your old address was, at gmail.com. And you can do either of two different things. Honestly, I'm not sure what the finer details of this are. I've now done both. They seem to work about the same. If you link accounts with Gmailify, well, it basically makes both accounts show up here and treats them both like Gmail accounts, even if they aren't. In our case, of course, they are. But if you're doing a different account, of course, then you could apparently get some more features. I've typically done POP3, which will also work for Gmail accounts. All it really does is fetches your email from that other account and then lets you use your current Gmail account to basically read that email and, in a moment, send email from that account. Up to you. I honestly don't have a strong choice either way. I'm more familiar with POP3, but Gmailify looks like a reasonable way to approach it, especially if you're using a Gmail account. I'm not going to go any further in this example because I just don't have something to set up this way. The next would be to specify the password for the account. Now, the issue, of course, is that if you have two-factor authentication turned on, Gmail doesn't know how to deal with two-factor authentication. What that means is that you have to create what's called a app-specific password. That happens in the Gmail account interface. You can simply go to settings for your account and search for app password, and it will lead you to the setting and the steps required to generate that unique password. Your regular password will not work if you have two-factor authentication turned on. But once you have configured your new account, the one we are currently have open here, to fetch emails from your old account, which is what we're configuring here with add a mail account, then all of a sudden, all of your email will show up in the single inbox. Now, what if you want to be able to send email from that old email address? Well, if you don't, you're done. If you're truly looking for a change and you no longer intend to send messages using that old email address, you're done. You're now sending all of your email from this new email address and still getting email that was sent to either of the old or new email addresses. Fantastic. However, if you want to be able to send as that old email address, one more step. We'll click on the gear icon again and go back to All Settings, Accounts, and Import, and you'll see that there is a section here called Send Mail As. And it includes, by default, the current, in this case, the new email address that you've set up. Once again, you would click on Add Another Email Address. You would specify the email address that you want to send from, which in your case would be whatever your old email at gmail.com was, and then you would move on. The next step then, of course, will be to confirm that you've got access to the old email address, that you actually are the proper owner of that account. Otherwise, well, anybody could configure this to send from your email account, and you don't want that to happen. So the next step is, of course, to send a verification, get the number, enter the number, all that kind of stuff. The step after that, which I'm not going to go to, then basically says, okay, you're configured. Now, if you have used Gmailify, or if you have used a Gmail account in both cases, you may not need to configure any specific information. However, it is possible that using POP3 or in this send configuration, you may need to configure the servers and the ports required for POP3 or SMTP access. Since you're dealing with just a Gmail account, Google already knows what those settings are, and it will probably just import or use the correct settings from the get-go. If not, you can search for the POP3 settings for Gmail, and it should give you the information you need. So after all is said and done, after you've done all this, what are you left with? Well, you have two email accounts, an old one and a new one. You can sign in to either of them at gmail.com. That's up to you. However, if you want to manage them from one place, then using either a desktop program that's configured to handle both, or if you configure your new account to fetch email from your old account, you've got a single place to deal with both. Now, there is one super important caveat that I need to point out here. We've been talking about Gmail. We've been talking about email specifically, your email address, sending and receiving email. But your email address identifies your Google account. And many people have much more associated with that account than just email. You may have YouTube or Google Drive or Google Photos or any number of a bunch of different Google services all associated with that old account. None of this changes any of that. All of your old photos, for example, if you were using Google Photos, are still in the old account. If you want to move them to the new account, that's on you. And that's true for any other Google service. Like I said, YouTube, your favorites, your playlists, Drive, the files that you have stored in Google Drive, and so on. So do be aware that changing your Gmail address not only creates you a second account for email, but it also creates you a second account for all of the Google services that you may be using associated with your old email address. Hope that helps a little bit. Hope that clarifies exactly what it means to get a new Gmail address. For updates, for comments, for links related to the topic and more, visit askleo.com/167066. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.